Tumamoc is a really important place for the community of Tucson to connect with nature in a way, you know, while they're getting some exercise. But this is also an 860-acre nature preserve managed by the university and Pima County. As part of that, we preserve native vegetation communities and wildlife communities here.
The desert laboratory is a thriving living laboratory in the heart of the city, right on the edge of downtown Tucson, on the edge of the Santa Cruz River, that has hundreds of years, well, really over 4,000 years of cultural history of people, close relationship with the space. And then more recently, for the last 115 years, it is a long-term science center.
One of our missions up here on the hill is to actively engage the public and the University of Arizona and U of A students in research. So we had a program funded by the Green Fund on campus, which is a campus sustainability fund. And we trained about 20 students in field methods and wildlife research, and also in plant phenology, to give U of A students an opportunity to do experiential education, real hands-on stuff, monitoring wildlife.
My name is Humberto Urrola. I'm a former student researcher up here for Tumamoc Hill. I just recently graduated from the University of Arizona with a bachelor's in wildlife conservation management and a focus in natural resources. So I've been a research technician assistant for Dr. Aaron Flesch up here for, well, I was before I graduated for about 2 years. So during his work, he like brought up this project that he would like for me to be a part of.
There's two mule deer sparring, just young males kind of practicing.
And I was like really, really excited just because, well, one, like mammals are like my specialty and I really enjoy working with them. And just it just gave me this like leadership opportunity that for me to be able to grow.
My name is Jacob Brown. I'm a junior studying in the School of Natural Resources and the Environment at the University of Arizona. My focus is on plants for the most part. The program lasted for about 8 months, and it involved, at least for me, being on the phenology team, looking at 21 different individual plants 2 times a week for 8 months. Checking for flowers or flower buds, and fruit, and just different interspecies interactions.
One of the things that's really exciting is that while, you know, the walker, as we walk the hill, we may casually glance at the deer or understand or see the roadrunner, or maybe see a bobcat if we're really lucky. This data being collected by the students really gives us a much more holistic and robust picture of the species that are here. Those that may not be, so we're absence is actually important, but if we're not detecting species, then that gives us, we have a large network of cameras. And then and in addition to that, we're starting to get some understanding of their distributional patterns and even some sense of abundances.
As the city grows and as Tucson residents have less of an opportunity to connect with nature, Tumamoc's value really increases because we have 860 acres of native wild desert right here at in our backyards, and it's a really important resource.
I think it's the best place to come here, that's why. Because most places, those cars coming, and that place is it's safe, and you can walk, and nobody bother you. Yeah, that's I like. That's why every time I'm coming here. And yeah, that's why I bring my camera and take nice pictures.
This is my first time here, We didn't see many animals, but definitely a lot of birds, and admiring the plants and the flowers and the cactus. So it was very beautiful up here.
Growing up in the Northwest, I don't think I really appreciated the outdoors. And I mean, while I was there, you know, you're in work and school and you kind of get into a routine. But when we moved down here, I think we definitely kind of appreciated the natural beauty and the available things that we had so close to home.
We just haven't had scientists that focus and specialize on vertebrates here on the Hill. Andrew Carnegie, when he started this facility in 1903, was focused on how desert plants make a living in such a harsh environment. And with the help of these 20 students, we began closing that gap of knowledge. There's still lots of work to be done, don't get me wrong. We just scratched the surface, but we do have really good species lists now for lizards, for birds, and for medium and large mammals now, following the Green Fund project.
I'm passionate about this because it's generally something that right now needs a lot of help, whether it be like studying into endangered species or studying into how to better manage areas that perhaps haven't been treated very nicely by humans throughout the years. It's just something that when I discovered like the plight of the conservation movement and whatnot, was really appealing to me that I wanted to take a part of.
It's a 3-mile trip, it's a good workout. And when I was working here, I really tried to do it as fast as possible just for fun. So I would be taking my study notes on the plants and then sprinting to the next plant. It was a good time.